What's the motherfucking deal, Sauce Nation? It's your boy Ed Honcho, aka at the real Ed Honcho on Instagram and Twitter. Or you want to catch me on those just delicious, tasty H-Town flavored Sauce Sports takes? You can catch me on Sauce Sports HTX on Twitter. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, first subscribe so you can become an ingredient to the sauce, because you know your input is always welcome. But if you don't know what Sauce Sports is, Sauce Sports is a Houston Homer channel. So we're talking about the Texans, Rockets, Dynamo, Dash, Astros. I thought I was going to forget. But anyway, we talk about professional, collegiate, high school, amateur, semi-pro, whatever, you know what I'm saying, however it may be, however it's coming to you. If it's an H-Town athlete, somebody affiliated with H-Town, we're going to put a little bit of sauce on it. We're going to splash a little bit of flavor on it. And today, if you've been following along, if you've been paying attention, you know this is part of the Know Your Texan series, and we're going in numerical order jersey wise. And so today we're talking about another gentleman, another possible UDFA, undrafted free agent. You know, the Texans have a series of having some success with UDFAs, and so hopefully this may be a guy who can become another one of those success stories. And we're talking about Curtis Drummond, number 23, but this is video number 20 in the series. Yes, I told you I'm gonna give y'all 100 videos before the first snap of preseason. I'm on the way. I'm telling y'all, I'm coming with it. I slacked up a little bit, but I'm coming more, and I got plenty of sauce for y'all. Like the boy Sauce Walker say, I said it's going to be a sauce overload. It was going to be a sauce sports overload. So anyway, we're talking about Curtis Drummond. I'm going to be honest. I did not know the boy had skills like he did. I was sleeping on him. You know, I've heard rumblings of this and that he's pretty good. I'm like, he hadn't really had a chance to show us, but we had some injury issues and some things like that. But let's talk a little bit about Curtis Drummond. If you know the Know Your Texan series, this is a positive situation. Yes, I'm still in the hot sauce sports studios because it's hot sauce right now because it's hot as hell in here. You know what I'm saying? Can't get no airflow going. You know what I'm saying? But until we do, it's all Gucci. I'm going to still keep bringing the sauce. I'm going to keep bringing the flavor. And y'all got to keep bringing the flavor because, like I said, y'all are a part of the sauce. Y'all are what makes the sauce fresh. Y'all are what makes it tasty. So y'all got to leave some comments down below. Let me know what y'all think about Curtis Drummond. And like I said, I'm going to give y'all a few things that you may or may not know. And if you know something that I don't mention, man, please drop that in the comment section below. Because like I say, I'm a fan just like y'all are fans. I like learning. I like hearing your opinion. You know what I'm saying? I see different views. Sometimes y'all bring things to light that I don't think about. And I truly do appreciate that. And everybody else in Sauce Nation appreciates that. So with that being said, let's talk about Mr. Curtis Drummond. We have a 6'1", 200-pound guy, safety. Didn't get caught up in with the rest of the Michigan State scandal, and I'm not knocking, I'm not clowning those guys. It was unfortunate, you know, Max Bulla and Mumphrey, and I think Mumphrey got an unfair shake. Like I said, I don't know the whole story, I don't know the whole deal, but we're not going to go into that. We're talking about Drummond today, okay? We're talking about this is this man's video, and as you can see in some of these highlights, that boy is a playmaker. I did not know that boy made plays like that. Let's talk about a few of his accomplishments, you know, collegiate accomplishment. Hadn't really made that splash in the pros yet, but hopefully this could be the year that the man gets to shine. This can be the year that the man gets to make his name known. So let's talk about a couple of things about number 23, all right? So first we said January 29th, 92. Talk about accomplishments. First team all Big Ten 2014, a two-time Big Ten champion in 2010 and 2013. Third team All-American, and he had the Tatum Woodson DB of the Year Award, which, you know, goes out to one of the best defensive backs in the country. So, I mean, obviously had to put his name in the mix. But the thing is that's crazy to me is that he went undrafted. So a lot of people say that, you know, for the skills that he does have, for his playmaking abilities, he does have some flaws that are very noticeable. A lot of people talking about him wrapping up, things like that. You know, the same old same stuff that comes with big hitters. You know, big hitters, big missers, you know, things like that. So, hopefully he's been able to improve on these techniques. Hopefully we'll see some things out of him, you know, maybe in the preseason. Hopefully we'll hear some things about him in camp, because like I say, these videos are about positivity. We want to see production from these players and all other type of words that start with P, and that shit sounds good. But like I say, just put a little sauce on Mr. Drummond. Like I say, the man is a playmaker, as you can see from these videos. You can see, so guys like that, you don't just lose that. I think he just hasn't had the opportunity to showcase his skills like he would need to, and hopefully this will be the chance for him to go ahead and make his name known. I think, like I said, that we have a lot of guys back there that have just been injured, have had little issues, and haven't had a chance to have the consistency necessary for them to make their name known at the safety position. I think that this guy's definitely going to be another one of those to watch in camp. So you definitely need to pay attention. Like I say, we have a lot of talent, a lot of guys that came in undrafted that I'm really excited about, that I really want to really keep a close eye on. like I say, as we go into the, you know, training camp in the preseason, because hopefully these guys can be contributors to the Texans, especially to that defense. I'd love to see a few pieces, few upgrades, if these guys can be playmakers and be impact guys. So, like I said, with that being said, you already know what I'm going to say. You already know the play. The next move, now that you've got a little bit of the flavor, you got to go ahead and drip the flavor on them. Go ahead and get that Sauce Sports shirt. If you ain't got one yet, go ahead and go to saucesports.com, and it'll take you. You just go ahead, order you one. Orange, red, blue, you know what I'm saying, black. You got the Liberty Blue. You know what I'm saying? The Battle Red, you know, that Astros, that Dynamo Orange, you know what I'm saying? We got that Cougar Red, that Rockets Red, however you want to come red with it. But you know what I'm saying? Go get the shirt. You know what I'm saying? If you got love for Sauce Sports, even if you don't get the shirt, man, I still got love for y'all because, like I said, y'all are the freshest ingredients in the world. H-Town, H-Town fans. Even though y'all who come and contribute to Sauce, y'all may not be fans, but y'all rocking with the Sauce Sports. I still got love for y'all, man. Like I said, I appreciate everybody who just takes a little bit of time to watch the videos just to contribute their own input. That's what it's all about. Like I say, man, it's a commentary, and I love speaking with y'all. So with that being said, I'm going to get up out of here. Like I say, Sauce Sports HTX on Twitter. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. Go like the Facebook page. I know a lot of y'all been asking me when I'm going to do more live streams. I think I'm going to start maybe posting that info more on the Facebook page. I'm not sure yet. I gotta figure that out how I can implement that out. Because like I said, I post a lot. I like this Facebook page because you can just post things directly without necessarily being a video all the time. So if you're not following me on Twitter, or you're not following me on the Facebook, that's where I kind of post some of that information. So if you wondered more about the live stream, go like the page or go follow on Twitter. With that being said, like I said, you want to get a game of Madden in, you want to get a game of 2K in, you want to get reckless and go do some GTA, whatever it may be, hit me on Honcho Saucy on Xbox Live, add me, you know what I'm saying, I add everybody. I love to get out whenever I got some free time. And so with that being said, deuce up, Sauce Nation, y'all be cool like y'all know how to be cool. I'm out.